Hey guys, it's Anthony of the Rag Company. If you're watching this video, you're probably wondering, what's up with the bead maker cure time? Is it needed? Is it necessary? Can you explain it further? So we're gonna be answering that question and more in today's FAQ video. So bead maker, a spray sealant that requires a cure time. Is that weird? No, not really. There's plenty of products out there that require cure times. Everything from ceramic coatings, the most common things, to even ceramic waxes and even other polymer sealants. But why does it require a cure time? Well, at the base level, right, bead maker contains monomers, right? These monomers that land on a surface that you're spraying or applying it to that need to flip over. And how this looks at a microscopic level is that these monomers look like a bunch of dot candies, you know, the ones that get caught in your teeth. And what happens is as the product is curing, all these are flipping over to where the bottom of that dot candy is now your new harder and slicker surface. So during that cure time, right, that is what is happening. That's what's going on. That's why bead maker is so slick. That's why it feels so good. And that's why it looks so good. So with that said, those are the hardening agents, right? There's other things in there as well, but that's kind of what's giving bead maker that bead maker look and feel. So why do you have to let it cure? For that reason, you have to let the product do its work and you have to let that product adhere properly for it to be able to be durable, for it to have the UV protection and even the anti-static protection. So anti-static, what does that mean? It means that is anti-static. It's gonna be anti-dust. But for the people that say, hey Anthony, my car is dusty after applying bead maker, my question back to you is, did you let it cure fully? And they say, well, yes I did, but it was outside and then there was a small dust storm and now my car is dusty. Can you explain that? Well, yeah, your car did not cure fully before that dust came through. So I tell people when it comes to bead maker curing, it is best to let it cure in an enclosed area, whether it's a garage or a covered area, anything to protect it from the elements and do not drive it. Some people apply bead maker, go for a drive, they say my car is dusty, the anti-static properties have not kicked in yet to prevent that dust. So how long is the cure time? It depends. It depends on your environment, depends on what kind of environmental factors that you're in. I tell people that if you're in a pretty dry, warm area, 2 to 3 hours is plenty of time. If you're in a wet area, if you're in a snowy area, a cold area, you want to give it more time, especially in humid areas as well. And so I tell people anywhere from 6 to 12 hours, the product should absolutely be fully cured, no questions asked, especially if it's in an enclosed environment. So during that time of curing, don't get it wet. Avoid getting it wet because that's diluting the product on the surface. You don't want that to happen. Let it cure fully, then the product can get wet. But other than that, it's pretty straightforward, guys. The curing time is important. You want to follow those instructions because that's how you're gonna get the most out of bead maker, and that's how you're gonna get the durability out of bead maker as well. So after applying it, avoid rain, avoid putting it in a dusty environment, let it cure fully, and you're going to enjoy bead maker to the fullest. And this applies to different application methods. So whether you're doing a full heavy application as a spray seal on its own, let it give it the cure time. If you're doing this as a drying aid, or if you're doing this for spot touch up, also let it cure if you can, but it wouldn't be as important as a full on application. So hopefully that answers the questions about cure time and bead maker. Hopefully it doesn't make it more confusing for you, but just remember the monomers being dot candies and the dot candies need to flip and not get caught in your teeth. So if you guys like this video, make sure you give us a big thumbs up, subscribe down below for more, and stay tuned for more videos right here at the Rag Company FAQ channel.